We are right now in northeastern Romania, in a region that is called Moldavia. And here's a site called the Painted Monasteries of Moldavia, or of Bukovina, which is the name for the historical region. I think you can go with either or. You will find everything about the site on the internet if you search either of those terms. The monasteries listed in the site, which is also registered with UNESCO since 1993, are built between 1487 and 1583. And we decided to visit six of them. But we're gonna try to just showcase you a bit of the architecture, a bit of the frescoes and paintings on them, because they're called the Painted Monasteries, since they have paintings outside and inside, on every single corner. It's crazy. It's nothing that I've ever seen in the rest of Europe. And I just want to inspire people to come here, because I feel like this is way too overlooked. Even though there's a few tourists here, it's like not the amount of tourists you would expect, and not the amount of tourists you would have if this would be, you know, in a more touristy country. Even today, the monasteries are used as pilgrimage sites. A lot of them have pilgrimage houses, and also nuns still actively live in many of them. The eight that were listed are all very different in their color schemes and their frescoes, and are all entirely unique. While the ones that the UNESCO lists are the best preserved ones, there's actually many more churches and monasteries in the area of Bukovina. So, you know, if you not just want to see eight, but you want to spend weeks visiting them, you easily can do that. Other than that, to give you a bit more of historic background, the reason why they painted so overly is because back in the Middle Ages, people weren't really literate, and the murals were meant to tell the religious stories, even if you couldn't read them. Which in my opinion makes it also a site of historic importance. And at the end of the day, these monasteries would be interesting to you no matter if you like history, art, architecture or just religion. So we've just been camping outside of the monastery walls for about 2 hours, which first of all is gonna make all of this chaotic because we now have to rush through all of them, which is fun. But also it's still raining, it probably won't stop raining. So if there's sometimes, you know, dots on the lens, that is something we can't control at all. I do hope that I can show you the monasteries to the best of my abilities though anyway. Our first stop is Bobota Monastery, built in 1530 and being very representative of 16th century architecture of the area. The paintings on the monastery were painted in 1532, so 2 years after the construction, and the exterior paintings are at large destroyed. You can kind of see the fragments of them, but they're not really there anymore. Meanwhile, the interior pictures have been remade, so we're gonna go inside in a second and you can probably see that. I've been to Romania before and I've seen the inside paintings of Romanian churches, but this is still crazy to me. Like the amount of work that must have went into creating this. Holy shit. Like literally every single corner of this, which this is just so different from the churches in Germany, for example. And this is the crazy part of me. I mean, think of 1532. How was that possible? It's crazy.
Zeliten.
Moving on to our second stop of the day, Voronet Monastery, which is mainly known for the type of blue that is used for the frescoes, even labeled Voronet Blue, which was built in 1488, and yet again it's described as being very characteristic for its period of time. This time around, we sadly can't show you the inside since filming and photographing is both forbidden. So you just have to trust my word that it's amazing and that you should come here to, you know, see it yourself. However, the outside here is very well preserved, so at least there's that, and I can show you at least some of what you can see here. After being built in 1488, the monastery was used for a couple hundred years until being abandoned in the late 18th century, but then at the end of the 20th century the nuns returned and now about 20 nuns live in the monastery actively. And luckily the weather just shifted, so, you know, the tides might be turning now. So let's get into the next monastery. And now we are at our third stop, Humor Monastery, which is much younger than the other ones, being built in 1530, but it had a similar destiny or history path or whatever you want to call it as Voronet, being abandoned in the 18th century and then reopened in the end of the 20th century. Humor was actually one of the first Moldavian monasteries to be frescoed, and together with Voronet it's said to be one of the best preserved, which I think the source means the exterior, which is also ironic because I'm saying that on the side that is less well preserved, but you've just seen the other side and that one is amazing. I'm still sure the inside is even more amazing, but again we can't really film it here, so you gotta come here yourself. Luckily, the tides have changed and the weather is a lot better now. I'm not sure if that's gonna go for the whole day, maybe I'm jinxing it right now, but we have sunshine, which is amazing and is making this a bit easier. Actually, a lot of the monasteries are known for their main color used, and here it would be a red-brownish hue, but I'm not sure how well you can see that on camera with the sun directly shining on it right now. The fourth site we're visiting is the Arbore Church, which I'm not even sure if this is a monastic site or has been one. Behind us there are like very low wooden walls, which suggests there might have been monastic things happening here, but I'm not sure about it. Either way, it's named after Luca Arbore, who apparently built it alone in either 1502 or 1503. I found different sources for that, so I'm not sure. And the paintings and murals were made in 1541 by a secular painter. So first of all, I'm amazed that we get to film another interior, which is probably just because this one is way less touristy, and we were just told that the murals inside of here are all original and not restored, which is crazy if you look at the ones especially around the roof and ceiling, because those are in so good quality, oh my god. Our penultimate stop is Suchevita, which is actually the last painted monastery that was built in the area, being only finished by 1584, with the murals being painted by 1596. According to my sources, Suchevita is actually considered the most complete in terms of architecture, exterior and interior paintings. Suchevita is also the biggest monastery when it comes to local nun population, because there's currently about 50 nuns that actively live here, and I actually have no idea if that's a lot. I know too little about monasteries, so that's just a fun fact for you to know.
Ja, dann gut.
And this is the point again where I have to tell you, you have to come here yourself because we cannot film inside. One more fun fact I have to add before leaving Suchavita, however, is that the color of this church is basically a mixture of green and blue, and you can already see that kind of from here, but when you go inside, it's really freaking obvious. And last but not least, we have Moldovita, which has very, very well-preserved frescoes and murals on the exterior that were painted in 1537. The original church was built in 1410, but was completely destroyed by mudslides and therefore had to be rebuilt on higher ground, which happened in 1532, basically 5 years before the murals were painted. And yet again, since it's one of the bigger touristy ones, we cannot show you the inside since it's forbidden to film inside of them. And I'm pretty sure that's not even preservation or anything. I feel like that's more like not taking away the reason from other tourists to come here. So yet again, if you want to see the inside, you gotta come here yourself, and it's definitely worth it, trust me.